This is Nicolas Maduro, president of Venezuela.
Y vamos a derrotar un golpe de Estado que pretende intervenir la vida política, echar de un lado la soberanía de Venezuela e instaurar un régimen títere.
And this is Juan Guaidó, self-declared president of Venezuela.
Han dicho la misma retórica de siempre, el mismo cuento chino de siempre, que es un golpe de la guerra económica. Ese cuento ya no lo sabemos todos, ¿cierto?
Two leaders, both trying to control the country and the narrative. Here's how they're doing it. Venezuela's state television is controlled by Maduro's government, so the opposition has been relying on social media to get its message out. On January 23rd, the opposition called for a large anti-Maduro protest and shared the images of flooded streets and squares online as proof of its popular backing. But state TV aired images of pro-Maduro crowds and speeches from his supporters.
Ellos creen en un país de comiquitas, de pantallas de televisión, de redes sociales. Nosotros creemos en la realidad de las calles.
Guaidó is advocating for a peaceful and democratic overhaul of the system. During the protests, he tweeted this video of a previous speech he gave in front of the National Assembly.
Nos mantenemos en la senda de la no violencia.
While Maduro is leaning on the establishment, with state TV broadcasting general after general voicing their support for him.
Garantizaremos
nuestra lealtad y subordinación absoluta
al ciudadano Nicolás Maduro Moros,
presidente constitucional de la República Bolivariana de Venezuela
y comandante en jefe de nuestra Fuerza Armada Nacional Bolivariana.
And airing the approval of the country's highest court.
Dejamos absolutamente claro nuestro reconocimiento a la autoridad legítima constituida del ciudadano Nicolás Maduro Moros como presidente constitucional de la República Bolivariana de Venezuela.
The list of countries recognizing Guaidó as the new president of Venezuela has expanded.
It is clear that Nicolas Maduro is not the legitimate leader of Venezuela. So the United Kingdom believes that Juan Guaidó is the right person to take Venezuela forward.
Guaidó retweeted world leaders, including those from the US, the European Council, and Argentina, and thanked them for their endorsements. On pro-Maduro state TV, the support for Guaidó was denounced as interventionism. And the superpower behind it?
El Imperio Norteamericano.
El gobierno de los Estados Unidos de Norteamérica.
Derrotaremos al Imperio Norteamericano.
Que se vaya bien largo el carajo el imperialismo con su presidente, su vicepresidente, sus senadores y sus instituciones.
And some countries seem to agree. Russia, China, and Turkey, among others, have vowed to stand by Maduro.
Ve, ben de doğrusu Rusya'dan dönerken Maduro'yu aradım ve kendisine bu noktada çok açık net demokrasi noktasında antidemokratik girişimlere asla prim verme dedim.
The fight over who will run Venezuela continues, with both leaders trying to control the message.